Dear students, in this session, we are going to deal with another important fruit crop, namely papaya. Papaya is also called as papava or papa. It originated in tropical America. In fact, Portuguese introduced papaya crop to India from Malacca during 1611 AD. At present, it is cultivated throughout India. Papaya produces fruits throughout the year. It requires less area for tree, comes to fruiting in a year, and is easy to cultivate and provides more income per hectare next to banana. It has a high nutritive and medicinal value. Papine, which is prepared from the dried latex of its immature fruits, is used in meat tenderizing, manufacturing of chewing gum, cosmetics for degumming, natural silk, and to give shrink resistance to wool. Besides, it is also used in pharmaceutical industries, textile and garment cleaning, paper, adhesive manufacturer, sewage disposal, etc. Papaya is eaten as fresh fruit. It is the richest source of vitamin A. In fact, it contains 2020 international unit of vitamin A per 100 gram of edible fruit and is sufficiently rich in vitamin C also, 40 milligram per 100 gram of the edible part. It also contains sufficient amount of calcium and other minerals. Red pulp type contains more of pro-vitamin A, cryptoxanthin, beta-carotene and alpha-carotene than the yellow pulp fruits, which means red types are more nutritive than the yellow types. Ripe fruits are used for making of jam, jelly, ice creams, etc. Unripe fruits can be used as vegetable. Let us now see the climate and soil requirement of papaya. Papaya is a tropical fruit. However, it also grows well in the mild subtropical regions up to 1000 meter above mean sea level. Temperature is one of the most important climatic factors which determine the success of papaya cultivation. Optimum temperature for papaya is 21 to 33 degrees C. Night temperature below 12 degree to 14 degrees C for several hours during winter months affects its growth and production severely. It is very much sensitive to frost, strong winds and water stagnation. Well-drained sandy loam soil is ideal for its cultivation. It grows well in deep, rich alluvial soils on banks and delta regions of big rivers of India. Papaya can also be grown in calcareous and stony soils provided with heavy dose of organic manures. Soil with a pH above 8 and low pH, that is below 5, should be avoided. Let us now see the varieties available in papaya. ICR Pusa varieties. One is Pusa Delicious. This is a gynodioecious line with medium tall plants, starts yielding 8 months after planting and has got good quality fruits. That is, the bricks will range from 10 to 13 degree. The fruit is medium sized, that is 1 to 2 kg with deep orange flesh, having excellent flavor. It is grown as a table purpose variety. Next variety is the Pusa Majesty. It is a gynodioecious line suitable for papain production and is comparable with that of TNAU variety, namely CO2, for papain yield. Fruits are medium sized, 1 to 1.5 kg in weight, round in shape and have better keeping quality. It starts fruiting 146 days from time of transplanting. This variety is also tolerant to root knot nematode, which is a serious menace in certain areas. Pusa Giant. This variety is very vigorous, sturdy, tolerant to strong wind. It is a dioecious cultivar with big sized fruits, that is 2.5 to 3 kg in weight, suitable for canning industry. Next variety is the Pusa Dwarf. It is a dioecious variety and the plants are medium sized, oval fruits. Plant starts bearing from 25 to 30 centimeter from the ground level and is comparatively drought hardy. These varieties also suitable for high density planting. Then Pusa Nanha, it is a mutant cultivar developed at IRA campus. The plants are dioecious nature. The plants are dwarf and grows up to a height of 1.06 meter height. Average yield per plant is 35 kg. This cultivar is preferred for close plantation. IHR Bangalore also has developed Cork honeydew. This is popularly known as Madhubindu and is cultivated for table as well as for processing purpose. This variety bears greenish yellow oblong shaped fruits with orange thick flesh and good flavor. It can be maintained by growing in isolation. Due to its excellent fruit quality, it fetches good market. IHR 39 and IHR 54 are also important varieties developed by Indian Institute of Agricultural Research, Bangalore. They are all gynodioecious lines, red flushed and very sweet in taste. Coimbatore has developed nearly 8 varieties, among which Kovan is a selection from cultivar Ranji. The plant is dwarf in stage, producing first fruit within 65 to 70 centimeters from the ground level. Fruit is medium sized, spherical, has smooth greenish yellow in skin, flush orange yellow and soft firm. It is moderately juicy with good keeping quality. The objectionable papain odor, which is characteristic of normal papaya, is practically absent in these fruits. CO2, it is a very important variety developed as a selection by then Agriculture College and Research Institute, Coimbatore under TNAU. Fruits are medium sized, overweight, greenish yellow, ridged at the apex, flush red in color, soft to firm, moderately juicy with good keeping quality. It is a suitable variety for the papain and is very popular among the papain industry. It gives 4 to 6 gram of dry papain per fruit or 250 to 300 kg of papain per hectare. CO3, it is a hybrid between CO2 and Sunrise Solo. Fruits are larger in size when compared to the Solo type and it exhibits all desirable attributes of that of Solo. The TSS, that is the total soluble solid, is as high as 13.8 degree bricks and average fruit ranges from 1 to 1.5 kilo. The fruits have a good keeping quality. Each tree can easily yield 100 to 120 fruits within a span of 2 years. CO5 is another variety developed from Washington and this is only suitable for papain production. It produces consistently 14 to 15 gram of dry papain per fruit. It gives 75 to 80 fruits per tree in 2 years with an average yield of 1500 to 1600 kg of dry papain per hectare, which is the world record yield as far as papaya is concerned. This Bandhanagar and Uttarakhand variety are also very famous. Panth papaya tree, which is of a medium height, which bears the first year itself, bearing first flower at a height of 115 to 130 centimeter from the ground level on strong stems. Fruits small to medium in size, 0.5 to 0.9 kg each. Large number of fruits per plant can be seen. Plants are tolerant to frost and waterlogging condition. Washington, which is suitable for table purposes. When ripe, skin attains a bright yellow color and average weight of the fruit ranges from 1.5 to 2 kg. Male and female plants are separate in this variety. Solo group of varieties are exclusively suitable for table purposes. The fruits are small with a deep pink pulp and sweet taste. Excellent for kitchen garden cultivation. Ranji is another variety developed in Bihar and popular in South India. Fruits are oblong with dark yellow pulp and sweet. Taiwan varieties are very also becoming popular. Taiwan 785, which is used as a table as purpose as well as processing purpose. The plant is dwarf in habit, producing the first fruit within 60 to 70 centimeter from the ground level. Fruits are oblong with thick orange, red sweet pulp. Each tree can bear up to 100 to 125 fruits in 1 year. It has got a good keeping quality and disease tolerant. Another Taiwan variety is Taiwan 786, which is a gynodioecious variety, also suitable for table as well as processing purposes. The fruits are oblong, tasty sweet pulp having few seeds. The plant starts bearing fruits from 100 centimeter above ground level Fruit weighs about 1 to 3 kg and has excellent keeping quality. Next, we will see the propagation method. Papaya is commercially propagated by the seeds. Certain cases, it is also propagated through tissue culture. The seeds lose viability in a short period. Therefore, the seeds should not be stored for more than one season. The seedlings in polybags are prepared. Due care is taken to avoid damping off of the newly germinated and young seedlings. The seedlings become ready for transplanting within 6 to 8 weeks. Now we will see the planting and planting season. Planting is done during the flowering season. Spring season is February, March. Monsoon season, June, July. Autumn season, October and November. Now we will see planting and cropping system. Seeds are sown in perforated polybags, that is 15 into 10 centimeter size, filled with 50% river silt and 50% cow dung. Seeds should be soaked in water for several hours before sowing. Watering should be done at 2 to 3 days interval after seed sowing. Papaya does not withstand waterlogging and strong wind. This is more important. Therefore, a well-drained upland with suitable wind barrier should be selected for its cultivation. The bed should be 1.7 meter wide and 20 to 25 centimeter high. There should be 30 centimeter drain in between the two beds. Bed should be raised before pit preparation. Pits of size 60 into 60 into 45 centimeter are prepared at 2 meter apart in the beds of 2 into 2 meter spacing. Manures and fertilizers like cow dung 15 kg, triple superphosphate 500 gram, gypsum 250 gram, boric acid 20 gram, zinc sulfate 20 gram are to be applied per pit 10 to 15 days before transplanting. Three seedlings are normally transplanted in each pit. So, a total of 7500 seedlings are required for 2500 pits per hectare. Now, we will see the aftercare requirement of papaya. Proper care should be taken to save the seedlings in field, especially against insect pests and heavy rainfall in the early stage. In frost-prone areas, there should be protection for small thatches or polythene structures against frost. Some extra seedlings are reserved which may be utilized for gap filling. In the space between the rows, intercropping leguminous plants for nitrogen fixing may be grown. It is advised not to grow crops like chili, tomato, brinjal, lady's finger to avoid the spread of virus and nematodes. Weak plants and affected plants are removed then and there. One plant per pit is normally retained. Earthing up is done 30 cm in radius around the plants. Now we will see the training and pruning. Observe when the flowering trees for first time. Flowers grow in the leaf axil at the age of 2 to 3 months. Papaya plants occur in one of the three sexual forms, normally male, female or hermaphrodite. Male flowers have no ovary and do not produce any fruit. They contain stamens bearing pollen which can pollinate a papaya flower with an ovary causing it to produce a fruit. Female flower bearing or gynodiaceous plants are normally retained. Male plants are removed and replaced with other stand by papaya plants. Now we will see the water, nutrient and weed management. Optimum soil moisture is essential for growth, yield and quality of fruits. Under low moisture conditions, floral sex shifts towards female sterility resulting in low yield. At times, over irrigations may cause root rot diseases. Thus, efficient water management is required in papaya cultivation. Number of irrigations depends upon soil type and weather conditions of the region. Protective irrigation is required in the first year of planting. In the second year, when its plants are loaded with fruits, irrigation at fortnight interval in winter and at 10 days interval in summer is needed from October till May. Papaya plants are very susceptible to waterlogging. Even 24 hour stagnation with water may kill the well-established plants. Manuring and fertilizer requirement of papaya. Papaya needs heavy doses of manures and fertilizers. Apart from the basal dose of manure supplied in the pits, 200 to 250 grams of nitrogen, phosphorus and potash are recommended for getting high yield. Application of 200 gram nitrogen is optimum for fruit yield, but papain yield increase with increase in nitrogen up to 300 gram per plant. Spraying of 0.5% of zinc sulfate twice and one spray of borax, that is 0.1%, may be done depending upon the nutrient status of the soil. Application of basaline or alachlorine or butachlorine after transplanting can control all weeds for 4 months. Now, we will see the special horticultural techniques. Removing of the unwanted male plant is an important operation in papaya. See, it is necessary to keep 10% of male plants in papaya orchard for good pollination when you cultivate dioecious varieties, wherein 50% of the plants are male and 50% plants are female. Whereas, in the case of dioecious or hermaphrodite plants, they produce only good quality fruits and should not be confused with the male plants while removing them from orchard. Weaker and diseased plants should be uprooted after ensuring one plant per pit. Earthing up should be done 30 cm in radius around the plants on or before the onset of monsoon to avoid water logging. It also helps the plants to stand erect. Use of growth regulators in papaya cultivation. Remove the side shoots of the stem as soon as possible. Cut the old, dry or diseased leaves and petioles. Thin the fruits which are poorly pollinated, malformed or pest infected one. Support the plant with stakes which should be tied with a rope, especially when bearing heavy fruits and during storm season. Pollinate by hand to increase the fruit setting and the percentage of large and normal fruits. Protection against frost. In frost prone areas like North India or higher altitude region, to save the young papaya plants from winter, the plantation should be done during October or November so that plants could be provided protection easily. Cover the plants with thatches or by making 3 support around the plants and covering with white polythene bags of the size of plants in first winter. In the second year, thick candy bags are wrapped around the fruits and apex during the winter season. Now, we will see the important diseases and disorders met in papaya production. One is the powdery mildew. It is caused by Oidium indicum or Oidium caricae. Infection is first apparent on the leaves as small, slightly darkened areas which later become white powdery spots. These spots enlarge and cover the entire leaf area. Affected fruits are small in size and malformed. Dusting the sulfur, that is 30 gram per 10 liters of water, or spraying calixin 75 EC 5 ml per 10 liters of water at 15 days interval can easily control this disease. Next disease is leaf blight caused by Corynospora cassicola. The disease first appears as a small discolored lesions which are irregularly scattered on the leaves. These spots increase in size and appear brown to gray in color. A light yellow zone surrounds the spot. A considerable reduction in the yield is observed. Spraying of dithenium 45 0.2% starting from the appearance of disease symptoms will easily control this disease. The third important disease is the damping off caused by Rhizoctonia solanae, which will affect the young seedlings in the nursery. Lesions are seen on the stem at or just above the soil level. The stem becomes watery and shrinks, followed by death of the plant. Control measures involve provision of well-drained soil. Seed should be treated with fungal culture of Trichoderma viride at the rate of 3 to 4 grams per kg of seed, or Kapton at the rate of 3 grams per kg of seed treatment to protect the newly emerging seedling. Fruit rot of papaya caused by Pythium aphanidermatum is also a serious disease. It is characterized by the appearance of water soaked patches on the stem near the ground level. These patches enlarge rapidly and girdle the stem, causing rotting of the tissues, which then turn dark brown or black. Fruit if formed or shriveled, malformed. Gradually the plant dies. Application of Trichoderma viride at the rate of 15 gram per plant mixed in well decomposed manure should be applied around the root zone of the plants at the time of planting to check the spread of this disease. Soil should be drenched with 2 to 3 liters of copper oxychloride at the rate of 3 grams per liter of water. Besides, application should be carried out regularly at 15 days interval from the time of planting. During fruit formation, plants should be sprayed with the same solution at the same time interval to completely eradicate this problem. Anthracnose disease is a serious problem. It is caused by Colletotrichum gliosporiidis. This disease predominantly appears on green immature fruits. The disease symptoms are in the form of brown to black depressed spots on the fruit. Initial symptoms are water soaked, sunken spots on the fruit. The centers of these spots later turn black and then pink when the fungus produces spores. Flesh beneath the spots becomes soft and watery, which spreads to the entire fruit. The affected fruit should be removed and destroyed to control the spread of the disease. The fruit should be harvested as soon as they mature. Besides, spraying with copper oxychloride at the rate of 3 gram per liter of water or carbendazim at the rate of 1 gram per liter of water or thiophenate methyl at the rate of 1 gram per liter of water at 15 days interval will also effectively control this disease. Papaya mosaic. This is a very serious virus disease attacking papaya in most of the regions, especially at all ages of group, but is more serious on young plants. The aphids are responsible for transmitting the disease. The disease symptoms appear on the top of the leaves of the plants. Leaves are reduced in size and show blister-like patches of dark green tissues alternating with yellowish green lamina. The infected plants show a marked reduction in growth. Fruits born on diseased plants develop water-soaked lesions with a central solid spot. Such fruits are elongated and reduced in size. The control measure involves removal and destruction of the affected plant, which will reduce the spread of the disease. Also, the losses can be minimized by controlling the population of the aphid by application of carbofuran 1 kg active ingredient per hectare at the time of sowing of the seeds, followed by 2 to 3 foliar sprays of phosphomidone 0.05% at an interval of 10 days starting from 15 to 20 days after sowing. These measures will definitely check the population of the aphids. Next important viral disease is the leaf curl of papaya. This viral disease is transmitted again by the vector white fly Bemisia dabasi. Severe curling, crinkling and deformation of the leaves characterize the disease. Mostly the young leaves are affected. The affected plants show a stunted growth with reduced fruit yield. Control measure involves removal and destruction of the affected plants to reduce the spread of the disease. Again, checking the population of white flies can also reduce the infection severity. Soil application of carbofuran 1 kg active ingredient per hectare at the time of sowing and 4 to 5 foliar spray of dimethyate at 0.05% concentration or metasystox at 0.02% or nuvacran at 0.05% at an interval of 10 days will effectively control the white fly population. Then last viral disease is the papaya ring spot virus. This is spread from plant to plant again by the aphids. The earliest symptoms on papaya are yellowing and vein clearing of the papaya leaves. This is followed by a very conspicuous yellow mottling of the leaves, sometimes severe blistering and leaf distortion. Dark green streaks and rings also appear in the leaf stalk and stems. Concentric rings and spots or C-shaped markings appear on the fruits. Symptoms persist on the ripe fruit as darker orange-brown rings. Control measure involves yield detection of the infected plants and prompt removal can check the spread of the disease. Aphids can be controlled by the application of carbofuran 1 kg active ingredient per hectare in the nursery bed at the time of sowing of the seeds, followed by 2 to 3 foliar sprays of phosphomidone at 0.05% at an interval of 10 days starting from 15 to 20 days after sowing. Now we will see the maturity indices and harvest requirement of papaya. Usually the fruits are harvested when they are full size, light green with a tinge of yellow at apical end. When the latex ceases to be milky and become watery, the fruits are considered suitable for harvesting. First picking may start at 14 or 15 months after planting. 3 to 5 pickings for one season are often taken, fetching about 30 to 35 tons per hectare. Suitable grading must be done before packing. Since the fruits are easily perishable, care should be taken to wrap the individual in paper and finally packed in crates. Special features of papaya cultivation. See, papaya, apart from the fruit, is also used for papine production. Crude papine in flakes or crude papine powder form with white brown or spray dried crude papine are the three types of papine extracted from raw mature papaya fruits. About 8 to 10 gram of final produce can be obtained from a well developed fruit weighing about 2 kg. Lancing the fruits, that is tapping, may be done 2 to 3 times, preferably during cool hours. The fruits after lancing can be used as a table for fruit or for preparing fruits or jams, etc. Now we will see the post harvest management. While picking the fruits from the tree, care must be taken that they are not scratched and are free from any blemishes. Otherwise, these are attacked by fungus and start decaying during marketing. The fruit yield of papaya varies widely according to variety, soil, climate and management of the orchard. On an average, each plant of improved varieties bears fruits weighing 40 to 75 kg in one fruiting season. On an average, yield of 60 to 75 tons per hectare may be expected in a season from an orchard of papaya. Now we will see the summary of papaya production. As I told you, papaya is a tropical fruit. However, it also grows well in mild subtropical regions up to 1000 meter above mean sea level. Optimum temperature of papaya is 21 to 33 degrees C with soil pH between 5 to 8. There are many varieties of papaya available developed by IRA, IIHR, TNAU, Pandanagar, etc. Papaya varieties are commercially propagated by seed. Kynodioecious varieties breed true to type and are preferred by commercial cultivars. Papaya is susceptible to virus diseases which are spread through insect vectors. The main fungal diseases are powdery mildew, anthracnose, damping off, stem rot, etc. Nematodes, mites, aphids and many other insects also cause damage to papaya, and insects act as vectors in spreading the diseases. Insects act as vectors for carrying pathogenic virus. The best way to control insect pest is the biological control. Use of egg cards of Malada bacillus walker 2260x per plant or 1 lakh x per hectare to control bites, aphids, white flies. Boron deficiency is the most common physiological problem. Apply 2 to 5 gram of borax per plant along with other fertilizers by side dressing at the beginning of the dry season.